Well, ladies, welcome to Blog Posts. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. I want you to always remember that. I don't care what you're going through, keep your joy. It will give you strength. Well, today is Relationship Tip Friday. And my tip for you today is make sure the person that you're going into the relationship with has the same belief system and value system that you have. You know, so many people are out here looking for love, looking for a feeling, looking for the stars and the moon to rise, and looking for the earth to shake, looking for really their lust to quake. You know, because most people, if they don't see what they want and if it's not pleasing to their eyes, they don't even want the person. They won't even give the person a chance. You know, get in your word. Seek God. Really see and understand how God brings relationships together. Really ask God to teach you his way. You know, because most of us do not know God's way of bringing relationships together. We know the worldly way. And I tell you, out here in the world, everything is screaming at you to go get, go chase, do it with lust, do it this way, do it that way. You know, you got to feel this way. You're going to know it by this. You're going to know it by that. You know, there's magazines out here. There's all kinds of videos out here. Tell you 10 steps to get a woman, 10 steps to get a man. You know, and ladies, I want you to beware. Because a lot of men are writing books for us women because we are the ones that buy them. You know, and they're always telling us what we need to do to get in shape. But always remember that in God, if God is requiring us as women to carry ourselves and be a certain way, what more is he going to ask the man when he done made him the head? He was created first. So he has to first operate out of what he's telling us to operate out of. It's not fair. And it ain't wisdom to tell the least of the relationship. And I'm not saying that in a bad way. I'm saying as far as that man is the head, he should be first partaker. That's just like us telling our children to do something that we're not doing. We have to be first partaker of that thing. We should be able to show them and walk this thing out. Not expect our children to walk it out while we do all manners of things. Wouldn't that look crazy? Well, these men are the same way. They need to be first partaker. It's easy to dictate and tell somebody else what to do. But what are you doing? Are you being a living example? Are you being the man that you need to be according to God's way and his will? Ladies, stop picking up everything and trying to get advice from everybody, especially when you are a kingdom citizen. Learn what God says. Learn what God says about every situation. Know that God is manifested in this person that you are putting in your life. Do you hear the force of God in them? Are they living what God is saying? Are they doing it? Are they walking it out? You know, do you hear yourself in this person? Do y'all have the same belief system, the same values? Do you both have the mindset of Christ? You know, it's more than just looks. It's more than just a fat wallet. It's more than just a big house and a fancy car. It's more than that. It's more than that. You know, because you got to live with this person for the rest of your life. You know, and if you don't even have the same way of, and not that you're going to agree on everything, and not that you're going to be ideally alike, but do you have the same foundational principles? It's going to play out in your life if you don't. It's going to make a difference if you don't. Babies, make sure that the person you're putting in your life, that you hear God in them, that you hear yourself in them, that your belief systems and your value systems are built on the same foundation. Be led by God, not by your eyes, not by the lust of your flesh. Babies, I love you and so does God. Have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful day. Smooches. Love you. Mwah!